The distance is 15 meters.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, the video that y'all all been waiting for, it's here. And that video is Mawuli. I'm going to pronounce it like American, Mawuli, because I've been warned not to talk about my nationality anymore. So I'm going to speak like a Wakandan in this video, okay? I am from Wakanda Republic, so I don't have a country. So you remember, Wakanda is an imaginary country. To avoid any form of problem for myself and for the good people of Ghana, I am going to refer to myself as someone from Wakanda, okay? Truly, I don't have a country right now, so you guys can adopt me. But first, I want to say welcome to another video, and thank you so much for keeping up with me on this series. Is this ever gonna end? I don't think so, because I don't want it to end. Come on, I don't want it to end. All right, so today we are going to vote. Guys, I'm excited to bring to you Mawuli. I think it's Mawuli. I want to sound very Votarian, very Ghanaian with this. Today we are taking a look at Mawuli Senior High School at the Volta region of Ghana, and I would like us to go there as we have always done to check this school out, and I'll be back. So Yenko Volta and Pacho Yenko.
Yeah.
The correct answer wins. So, an object undergoes a displacement 9 meters deep, followed by displacement of 12 meters north. Find the distance.
The distance is 15 meters.
Yes.
Okay,
So I want to ask you, what is this? Ghana, who offend you? Pacho, who offend you? Daddy, mama, who offend you? Hey, the schools here, you put in all your booze. You know, that is what I want to see. And I love the fact that this is not just in Accra or Cape Coast alone, or Kumasi, energy. It's not just in Kumasi, but this is spread across almost every part of the country, and that is what I stand for. I have seen so many videos, places I have never heard before in Ghana, and I'm seeing their schools online, and these schools are looking beautiful. I mean, they can stand strong with the schools in the city. That is what you are talking about. And that is why I'm still here doing this video. So if I have not gotten to you, relax your mind, okay? I'm coming to your school, all right? As we have always done, first before we do any other thing in Mawuli. So as we have always done, we should go say hello. All right, let's go check out the ex-student of the school. And I will be back. Let's go to see as they come back to give back. And I will be back. Let's go.
So we have all students of Mawuli School here, and we have Mr. Richard Nyaku, who is the president of the Old Mawuli Student Union, and we also have Dr. George Ofori, who is also the executive council member, and they are here to tell us about their 75th anniversary launch. And so we're having more conversation about that. Good morning and welcome to Metro TV.
Good morning.
It's good to have you here.
Thanks for the opportunity.
Oh, yeah, welcome. So, and Mr. Richard here, Nyako, is the president. And he said he's popularly known for a particular name. For all those who are from Ola School, I'll let him mention the name so that you become accustomed to what the name is. He said it's what?
Chief Butelezi.
Chief Butelezi.
Yes.
Okay. And what does he mean?
Oh, Butelezi was one of the people who helped initially with the fight for freedom for South Africa.
Okay.
Yes.
But why did you pick that name? Did you fight for something in school?
I always fight for things.
Oh.
I always fight for freedom. I always fight for justice.
Okay.
I believe that everybody must be treated with fairness.
Core respect. Okay.
So I stand for those values.
Yeah.
I guess that is how the name came about.
Okay. So which year are you representing?
1994. Yes.
I wasn't born by then.
Wait till you hear the year he represents.
And if you weren't born when he talks about 1994, I don't want to tell you 1970.
What course is that?
I wasn't born.
You weren't born. Wow. And what did you study?
In Mawuli?
Yes.
Oh, Mawuli, I did a science.
Science, wow.
Up to the sixth form.
Okay. Yes. And you?
And I did general arts.
Let's go.
I have a lot of YouTubers that I met way before my channel got to where it is now. Before we get to this point where my channel is now, I've met a lot of Ghanaians YouTubers, and there's one thing they all have in common is that they are drawn to me because this Ghana love, it has come from way back, and some of them can attest. People like a lot of channels here on YouTube, they come to me like, hey, my sister, all because of what I was saying about Ghana unconsciously, all right? So a lot of them have been telling me that's their school, and I didn't know it was going to take me this long to get there. So, but finally, I'm glad I am here, and I'm glad we are on this today. So let's go back to the school and check out everything that we can find, and I will be back as always. Yenko. I'm I'm seeing so many schools online, and I'm also seeing all of your requests. The truth is, I'm seeing your request to do some schools and all that. I'm going to do all alone. Let me talk. Like I said, I will a minute. Okay, it might take me a while, but surely we shall do it. Okay, we shall do it. When I'm tired, I'll take a little break. But just before you know it, I'll be back. But I don't intend to be tired. Come on, come on. Who get tired of seeing beautiful things, especially education, something that is going to give back to the future? I love to see. I'm living in the future, so I can't be, I shouldn't be tired, right? So if I've not gotten to your school, relax. I'm coming to your school, okay? I love to see everything that I'm seeing. I love the fact that it gives me this peace of mind, knowing that whatever I'm saying here, I will stand before God with a smiling face. Maybe God may say, oh, you have sinned because I saw you fighting on social media for Ghanaians. I saw you dragging people that are dragging Ghanaians, and maybe this is your punishment. Otherwise, I don't think God will be angry with me in any ways, because everything I'm putting out here is nothing but the truth. All right. And that is what I stand for. And I have been told to be very free. By some Ghanaians have advised me to be free with the reviews that I'm giving about schools. If I go to a school and I don't feel satisfied, I should call the alumni of that school to go do something about it. All right. So, but I've not seen any reason to complain, because they are doing well. Sometimes we don't see the videos of the alumni and all that they have done, because some people don't know that they are supposed to film and post for memories. But I believe all the schools in Ghana are doing amazing, and I love what I'm seeing. Okay, I'm going to your city, village, town, region, anywhere, just name them. I'm getting to you. Okay, all I need is a little patience for me to work on. And I think it's safe to say that this is one of the oldest schools in Ghana. I'm proud of everything I'm seeing here. Okay, I'm proud of everything I'm seeing here, and I hope that you guys will adopt me. Okay, adopt and love me, give me love, because right now I'm countryless. I can't talk about my country. I can't even call myself a national of anywhere. So I will from now on call me Lily from Wakanda, okay, an imaginary country. So if you want to adopt me, feel free to do so. Okay. All right, so I'm glad I did this video, and I love the fact that everyone is welcome to the system. You're rich, you are not rich, you are this, yeah, it doesn't matter. Just pass your exam and you'll be taken into one of these schools who accept you, give you free food. But wait, oh, Ghana is rich, oh. Let's just pretend that, okay, fine, they are giving, let's just say, fine, the free education in Ghana, I mean, free senior highs in Ghana. You don't pay anything. Yeah, it's fine. You don't have to pay, right? Because it's your country, and this is like student loan or something. It is given to you so that in future you can impact your society, your community. They want to believe that you will turn up well if they give you their best. Fine. But what about the food? Because some of these schools are densely populated, like over 5,000 students in one school, and they eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and they don't just eat anyhow food, they eat very well. How do you guys get money? Ghana is rich. Ghana is rich. Seriously, there's no bigger wealth than that. I am a mom, and I'm raising 3 kids right now all by myself, and I know what I go through. Like, food can keep you poor. I don't know if you know that. So, but Ghana is pulling this off just like nothing. Really? Ghana is rich, honestly. This is what I'm saying. Ghana is rich. And I love the fact that they are investing into the future. And I love the fact that Ghanaians themselves do not forget themselves. No matter where a Ghanaian goes, a Ghanaian will always come back home to give back to his or her community. And this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about, okay? Adopt me so that I'll be here to see all the beautiful things that happens, that will happen in future. And I want you to know that I believe so much in you, and I'm praying that the good Lord continue to uphold your country, continue to impart you, continue to strengthen the government. And I'm praying that God gives everyone the ability to make the best choice that will benefit everybody. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next one. Ciao.